And that's what I mean by live performance. It's so nurturing. It's healing. It's exciting. It's challenging. It's live music, live theater.
But the way that you must travel and perform different recitals, different orchestras, traveling all over the world, and wherever you land, people want you to be in your finest voice. They want you to give the performance of a lifetime. And I can't imagine what kind of pressure that puts on you. And you are the quality control, aren't you? How do you exert quality control when everyone else has got so many demands on what they want to see from you?
Well, and I'm glad you pointed that out. That's a very good question. For example, for this concert, for the opening of the Toronto Symphony, there's so many details, and there's so many people working behind the scenes to make this a wonderful evening. I'm sure it's a gala event. There's probably a dinner or a reception or all of this, and lots of fanfare having to do with it. At the same time, the orchestra, the chorus, the maestro, and I have to be on point. We have to be very much in form, as you say. Flying here, I was flying from California, and the stewardess came to me and she said, "Are you the opera singer?" I said, "Yes." So from that moment on, I could feel the tension sort of between me and my seat partner. He had been reading for the whole first half of the flight. We were fine. All of a sudden, now, I became his best friend. And he wanted to know how I got into opera, how I started singing, how have I been doing this all my entire life, and how do I manage to keep my voice, as you say, and flying. I said, well, one thing I try not to do is talk on airplanes.
Do you wish sometimes it could be like a violin player? Would you simply put the violin in a case?
Wouldn't that be nice?
How different would that make you?
Oh, wow. I think